Sagar. Sagar is a 16-year-old boy. He came to us last year. And he came in first time with his aunt, his mother's sister. So the aunt told us that apparently a year back, which was in early 2011, Sagar met with a car accident on the way, somewhere on the highway to Kullu Manali. And there were a lot of people in the car. His parents were also there. So in that road traffic accident, the mom, the dad, Sagar, they got injured. But out of the 5-6 people, Sagar was the one who was severely injured. He had a brain injury. So they were taken to a hospital, Mission Hospital, Manali. And his parents were also injured, but they were not that severely injured. So the aunt came to know about this, that the sister's family has met with an accident. So the aunt went to the hospital. And for 2-3 days they were there. Sagar was hospitalized. He had some sutures on his brain. There are no medical reports available of that time. So yeah, for 2-3 days the mother, the mom, dad, Sagar's parents were also there in the hospital. And then they apparently left Sagar in the hospital and they went missing. So the aunt told us that ever since she's not heard about her sister and the brother-in-law. So she was the only person possible to have taken care of or taken responsibility for Sagar. So the aunt said that it was difficult for her also. She herself is living like by the end of a meet with her family. But then she decided that she'll take him home. So after a couple of days, about 10 days or 12 days, he was still at the hospital. And then she brought Sagar to Kullu. And then ever since, Sagar has been staying with them. The aunt tried to contact them in Nepal. So basically, Sagar and Sagar's family are originally from Nepal, but they keep on moving to Manali or through other tourist places in the touristy season. Or basically, they are laborers. So wherever there is work, they keep on moving. So they don't even have a place in Nepal. So it was difficult for her to contact them. And then she has not heard about them ever since. So just last month, Sagar is one of the most regular kids who comes to the unit. What I have felt is he can empathize with himself. You empathize with others' situation. But what I have felt with Sagar is that he can very well empathize with himself, not sympathize. Though his cognitive abilities or his age is not really that mature to have that empathetic view about his situation. But I've always felt that he's always had this positive outlook to whatever his situation is. And so he's been coming to us regularly. Just last month, we were supposed to, there was a function in Manali. So we thought he could, he's a very good singer. We thought somehow he could take part in the annual day. So he was supposed to, we were supposed to start practicing for whatever we were supposed to do. So we thought either dance or song, but we'll do something with him. So he was supposed to come the next day and he did not end up coming. So I thought, oh, maybe he was a little nervous about the entire thing. So he must have not come. The second day also he did not come. The third day also he did not come. So that was kind of unusual for him to miss out without telling us any reason for like 3 days in order. So we called him at the home and we could not get through the number, the aunt's number. Finally, after a week, we spoke to the aunt. And for the week, Sagar had not come to the unit. And in the meanwhile, we read in the newspaper that there was one car accident which happened in Kullu. And in that, one lady died. So it was in the news and it was a conversation we had in the office one day. So when we spoke to the auntie tells us that apparently the lady who died in that car accident was Sagar's mom. So yes, suddenly after a year, this mom comes and they say like the karma took care of it. I mean, for whatever reasons, they must have left Sagar and have gone. I'm sure they must have had their reasons. And we came to know that the accident, like she's no more. So Sagar had to, according to the Hindu rituals, Sagar had to do the last rites. So When Sagar came back after a week, the next week he came, and again the first thing he was like, Didi, I'm sorry that, you know, I could not come for a week. He told me because there were these some pujas and some rituals happening at home and he had to be there. He told me that somebody in the family, one of his aunt, she died in the accident, so that is why he had to stay home. And he was like, but even when there were so many people in my house and this puja was happening, I was still doing the exercises which you told me to do at home. And when I spoke to him about that and I heard his side of the story, he just knew that somebody in the family died. He doesn't know or understand that that was in fact his mother. And nobody has really spoken to him about it. So whenever I have tried to talk to him about his family, even before this incident happened, he does not really, I mean, he tries to avoid it or doesn't come up with any meaningful answers. I mean, the best he tries to avoid it. So I still don't know what he thinks about his real parents or his family. He very well knows that he is living with his aunt. So I wonder whether what he feels about where his parents are.